Welcome to Organization-Wide Defaults, the fifth video in the Who Sees What series. These videos provide admins the basics on visibility and data access in Salesforce. Previously, we granted org and object access in our Salesforce org to folks at AW Computing. Now it's time to think about the baseline level of visibility we want for each object across the entire org. When we created our sales apps and object access permission set, we set up the following permissions for records that the inside sales reps own: accounts, create and read. We don't want inside sales reps to edit or delete accounts. Contacts, create, read, edit, and delete. So inside sales reps can update information when talking to customers. Opportunities. Inside sales reps have create, read, edit, but not delete, since we don't want reps deleting opportunities. Cases: create, read, edit, and delete. These settings apply to records owned by each inside sales rep. But what about records they don't own? Do we want them to have the ability to edit and delete each other's contacts, or to read and edit each other's opportunities? Organization-wide defaults determine what access and permissions users have to records they don't own. We're going to go over a few options: public read, write, transfer, public read, write, public read only, and private. Public read, write, transfer allows non-owners to view, edit, and change ownership. This public ability to transfer ownership only applies to leads and cases. In this example, users can view, edit, and change ownership of leads they don't own. For all other standard objects, only the owner or someone above them in the role hierarchy can transfer ownership. You can also make an object's records public read-write. Here, users can view and edit accounts, contacts, and assets that they don't own, but they can't transfer ownership. Public read only means users can view and edit all the records of an object, but they can't edit them or transfer ownership. In this example, users can see contacts that they don't own, but they can't edit or transfer them. The most restrictive setting is private. Here, users can't even see opportunities they don't own. Let's set up the default sharing settings. Sharing settings are also known as org-wide defaults, or OWD. They're located in Setup, under Sharing Settings. Here, we'll set the default access level to each object for the entire organization. Right now, access to all objects that a user doesn't own is relatively open. This column, Grant Access Using Hierarchies, works with the role hierarchy, which we'll cover later in this video series. At AW Computing, all of their employees can view and edit leads, but they only want owners to be able to transfer a lead to a new owner. So they set leads to public read-write. All of their users should be able to view account and contract, and they want users to be able to update each other's records, so they make this public read-write. In this org, they'll let all users update contacts, so they leave this as controlled by parent. Opportunity information is often confidential, so they set opportunities to private. This means that opportunity records are only visible to their owners and to users above them in the role hierarchy. Users cannot see each other's opportunities unless an opportunity is intentionally shared. As we mentioned, role hierarchy and sharing are covered later in this series. We change case access to private as well. We leave the other settings as they are and click Save. In a large organization, changing the sharing settings takes some time. If you are setting up a new organization, this process is typically very quick. Now we've set the default sharing settings for AW Computing. When assessing how org-wide defaults work in conjunction with object access via profiles and permission sets, remember that object permissions determine the baseline level of access a user has to all records. Org-wide defaults can then further restrict these permissions on records a user does not own. Let's use the contact object as an example and see these settings in action with our inside sales rep, Mimi Sato. Let's say we set object permissions to create, read, edit, delete, and the org-wide default is set to public read only. Mimi is now able to create new contacts. However, clicking the edit and delete buttons on contacts Mimi does not own results in an insufficient privileges message because the org-wide defaults are public read-only. She can, of course, edit and delete contacts she does own. If we leave the org-wide default the same and remove all object permissions, even read, then Mimi isn't able to view any contact records anywhere in the system, nor can she find them by searching or viewing reports. In our last examples, we'll set the permissions to create, read, edit, delete, and the org-wide default to public read-write. Then Mimi can create new contacts. She can view contacts she does not own as well as the ones she does own. And she has edit and delete permission on all contacts. To learn more about visibility and access, check out all the videos in this series. Up next, we'll dive into record access and role hierarchy. You can search for these topics in Salesforce Help or come join us on the trail at trailhead.salesforce.com. Thanks for watching.